the power of a Congress to grant franchises, the lack of isolation of NTC when it comes to the political pressure. So what's the way out here? And can you actually rely on Congress to help solve this dilemma?
Okay, let me address the last question first. The quick answer is no, we cannot rely on Congress, and that's why we have to rely on public pressure for it to do the exact opposite of its vested interests. Okay, what can be done? I said this time and again, we have to remove the power of Congress to grant, or to be more specific, the House of Representatives, to grant congressional legislative broadcast franchises.
But to do that, do you have to tinker with the Constitution?
Okay, I think a lawyer would be in a better position to comment on that. But from what I know, Carmina, from my limited understanding of the law, we need to abolish the Republic Act that established the law pertaining to broadcast franchises where you need the approval. What was referenced there was the Philippine legislature, because in the 1930s, we were still under colonial rule. Mm. That's what I think, at least. But a lawyer may be in a better position to comment if it requires constitutional changes.
But even so, Professor, you're going to have to rely on Congress to sort of to amend, to relinquish. But can you actually expect them to do that, given that, you know, this benefits them as well, having that power over giving franchises. Yeah. Go ahead.
Yes, actually, that's an excellent point, Carmina. We cannot rely on them, and that's where public pressure comes in. And I'm sorry if this sounds a bit vague, but we have to still try, okay? Because even if we are unsuccessful, you know, campaigns like this are worth pursuing and worth pushing for. And if ever they are confronted, let's say, with a House bill or a House resolution pertaining to the stripping away of such power to grant broadcast franchises, if they reject it, then it exposes them even more of, being too much interested in perpetuating themselves in power and spreading their power and influence even to the media. It's just like the anti-dynasty bill. It's been there since time immemorial. And it further exposes the different congresses for their refusal to approve a law that would hit at the very structure of Congress.
Mm. What do you think about people who tend to, you know, trivialize what is happening now and just whittle it down to, you know, what goes around comes around? Is it as simple as that? Or is there something more to this that we really should be concerned about?
Okay, first of all, Carmina, we cannot blame the people if they think that SMNI had it coming. And that, as you said, what goes around comes around, nakarma rin sila, puti nga sa kanila. You know, such discourses are understandable given the notoriety of SMNI. And right now, the running joke in the journalism education community is, if you want to teach journalism, let them watch SMNI and then tell them that it's the exact opposite of journalism. That's it. They can get their degree. But levity aside, Carmina, we have to further defend the context, and that's why we have to be more nuanced in our analysis of what SMNI is going through. Mm. Because it's not just simply the discourse on what goes around comes around, and that never mind if the laws are repressive as long as it is useful sometimes to our interest. We have to be more long-term, and that's why, Carmina, even if we are a bit skeptical about Congress giving up its power to grant broadcast franchises, a House bill or a House resolution should be done. So if some of the members of Congress are listening right now, I hope we can get this going. And since I have some time next year, I'm more than willing to help out if deemed necessary.
All right. And talking about next year, you know, 2023, it gave our industry a lot, right? I'm not even talking about 2020, but 2023, you know, there were some bright sides to it. There was also this, as you correctly pointed out, it can have a chilling effect. It does have a chilling effect. But come 2024, where do you think new cycles will be? What will influence new cycles come next year?
Well, we need a separate segment on that because in terms of technology, for example, artificial intelligence is a major issue, and that's why it's necessary for media to come up with concrete deadlines. Concrete guidelines that would ensure that deadlines are met, but at the same time, ethics would still be observed. But of course, on a more political side, Carmina, we have to ensure that the culture of impunity will end, because we would see more of it in the near future. We might even have situations where the killings of journalists would continue, and that harassment and intimidation would still be the order of the day. Mm-hmm. Right now, Carmina, red tagging has become normalized, and that's why it's such a welcome relief, going back to the case of SMNI, that for many of us, we think that they deserve to be shut down, albeit the chilling effect should be closely observed. And that right now, those who cry press freedom, those who cry violations of freedom of expression, they are actually the ones perpetuating that when ABS-CBN, Rappler, Bulatlat, and other news media organizations had to go through, a lot of things right now. So that's the problem, Carmina, with 2024. We have to remain vigilant, and we have to challenge the powers that be to make sure that the necessary reforms would be done. And I think, given these developments these past few weeks, two major policy reforms would have to be made, if not reviewed. Number one, the power of Congress to grant legislative franchises. And number two, the probable abolition of the MPRCB, given its tendency to censor, even if sometimes they do responsible gatekeeping, as in the case of SMNI. Mm-hmm. So we cannot have it both ways. We cannot just have faith in, quote-unquote, the powers that be, that they would do the right thing. We have to institute the policy measures that would force whoever's in power that they have to do what is right, because that is the law.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Professor Danilo Aro there, he's an associate professor at the UP Journalism Department. Merry Christmas to you. Thanks for making yourself available and accessible the whole year round, and we hope to have more of these conversations next year. Thanks again, Prof. Dan.
Yes, happy holidays to you and to your loved ones, Carmina.
And to you too. Take care.